The Knicks' problem was not that they traded Kristaps Porzingis for cap space, draft assets, and a young player in Dennis Smith. That made sense to me even without bringing in these free agents. Your problem is they wanted to tell the world they had these free agents locked up, so they created an unrealistic level of expectation, and when you sell hope, this is kind of the position you put yourself in. I like Julius Randle a lot. With the third year being a team option, that's a smart deal. I'm a big fan of Bobby Portis and a competitive atmosphere for your young guys for minutes with a guy like Bobby Portis who's hungry. He's a dog, Bobby Portis, man. He works very hard. I like that deal, too. I don't mind the Reggie Bullock deal. He can shoot the ball. You know, a guy like him, if he starts to defend a little bit better, gets hot shooting from three, that could be a major trade asset. The Taj Gibson deal has me scratching my head a little bit. I got to be frank about that. The truth of the matter is I don't know how he fits the age trajectory. And when you just brought in Randle and Portis, even if you want to tell me he's a trade asset, are the minutes even going to be available to him? So yeah, I do like some of the things that they've done. There's certainly been some head scratchers. And by the way, you didn't get the free agents that you wanted to go out and get. Let's focus on signing players instead of sending out statements during the main period of the free agency time when everybody's trying to get guys and sign off. The Knicks have to separate themselves from all this crazy perception stuff. And this owner, really, who keeps saying he's going to be in the background, has to commit to being in the background and let his basketball people be front and center, because the perception of the owner has hurt the Knicks in free agency with players more than anybody around Madison Square Garden wants to admit.